Hello, welcome to another brief Let's Play. Dear Esther, of course, as you can see, Landmark Edition, which came out last year, 2016. Yeah, quick little game from what I understand. Going in blind, I know something about the development of the game. But nothing about the story, if there even is one. I know there's limited to no interactivity in this game. It's basically like you're walking through a story kind of thing. Before I get into stuff, audio, I'm going to make this a little bit louder because I seem to be okay. I'm going to go up to like that. Interesting is you can change the speaker configuration to 4 speakers, 5. But I'm not going to mess with that. Restart some music though. Closed captions I have enabled and large captions enabled. So if those are really large, like if they take up a lot of the screen, I might change those. Video, this is all standard stuff. Crosshair. I don't know if I need a crosshair. I'm not interacting with anything. I mean, probably. I have the texture detail up high. Anti-aliasing was down to like 2 or 4x. I put it up to 8x. It's the highest available. So. V-Sync. Foliage. Enable, disable. Done. I haven't changed anything. Keyboard and mouse. Reverse mouse. Yeah. Controller I'm not using. Language is going to be English. Also available French, German, Spanish, Polish? Russian? Not sure. So, those are your options. And begin. Okay, director's commentary, we're putting not on, of course. Progress is saved at the end of each chapter, of which there are 4.
Dear Esther, I sometimes feel as if I've given birth to this island. Somewhere between the longitude and latitude, a split opened up, and it beached remotely here. No matter how hard I correlate, it remains a singularity, an alpha point in my life that refuses all hypothesis. I return each time, leaving fresh markers that I hope, in the full glare of my hopelessness, will have blossomed into fresh insight in the interim.
Right, so options. I'm turning off the large. It's quite noisy, isn't it? Is that audio? Yeah, it makes a lot of sound. Large caption disabled. I guess I don't have to apply that. Can we go into the water? Yes, apparently. Oh. I am, like, not in control at this point.
Come back.
Oh, okay. Yeah, don't commit suicide just yet. I mean, I don't know, you know if I can pick anything up or do anything with anything. There's no, like, run feature or anything. No crouch, no jump. Oh. I don't even have to turn anything on. It's just there. Now, this was, originally a mod for the Source Engine, which, as many of you may know, is the Half-Life 2 engine. In 2008, I believe, I wrote that. Yeah, 2008. And it was released commercially in 2012. The game studio was originally... like, a part of a college. I can't go through there. Probably like a college experiment. Okay. I have a feeling we're looking at chemistry. I don't know. We got helium? I have no idea. So there's a... Wait, there's a door here. Taken... Oh, there must be the door taken off of here. What's this magazine? We can zoom in as well. Can sweetness and honesty find happiness together in a yogurt? Pillsbury. Okay. Product placement. So we got some a score here. Pages from a score. I don't know what language. That looks like Russian again, or Polish. Maybe Russian. So then anyway, the game was released again. Re-released last year. For Xbox One, PlayStation 4, and re-released for Windows and Mac. Previously only available on those platforms, as far as I know. I don't know about Linux, but... as the landmark edition featuring improved graphics and stuff like that. Improved voiceovers, as far as I can understand it. So that, yeah, more of that paint. I feel like something is going to jump out at me, but I am reasonably assured that there's no jump scares or anything in this game. Luminous paint. Alright, so this is, yeah, luminous paint. So who's painting with luminous paint? Maybe I did it. I'm the one. So obviously heading that way, and we gotta go this way. You know me too, I like to test the boundaries. Well, you might know me. I like to test the boundaries of games. Like, what happens if I just go in the water? The high road or the low road? This way. More luminous paint? Looks awesome, guys. It really does. I instinctively try to go faster. But you cannot. There's a spiritual successor to this game. I guess spiritual meaning it's not an actual true sequel. They're called Everybody's Gone to the Rapture. If I can get that for less than $19.99, as it currently is on Steam, I'll buy that as well. Unless I get it as a gift or something else like that. It's a little longer than this game, but still like 5-6 hours, and really don't want to spend $20 for 6 hours of gameplay. If I can help it. I assume if I go in the water here, the same thing will happen. Coca-Cola. A green can. Is that the Christmas edition? Now, a lot of people like to call these games walking simulators. Which, I don't know, to me seems kind of silly. They call it that because there's really no interactivity. The lighthouse. How do I get over there? That's back where I came from. I'm guessing it's beyond where I was. But it's kind of silly to me to call it a walking simulator. I mean, you don't call...
There was once talk of a wind farm out here, away from the rage and the intolerance of the masses. The sea, they said, is too rough for the turbines to stand. They clearly never came here to experience the becalming for themselves. Personally, I would have supported it. Turbines would be a fitting contemporary refuge for a hermit. The revolution and the permanence.
Quite poetic. Anyway, yeah, it's like you wouldn't call Call of Duty a shooting simulator. An arrow. I guess we're going that way. You wouldn't call the Elder Scrolls a medieval simulator, would you? I mean, some people might. So I'm playing this blind as you...
Dear Esther.
No?
I found myself to be as featureless as this ocean, as shallow and unoccupied as this bay, a listless wreck without identification. My rocks are these bones, and a careful fence to keep the precipice at bay. Shot through me caves. My forehead a mount. This aerial will transmit into me so. All overexposed, the nervous system, where Donnelly's boots and yours and mine still trample. I will carry a torch for you. I will leave it at the foot of my headstone. You will need it for the tunnels that carry me under.
That's not a tunnel. I thought it was going into a tunnel. The aerial will transmit it. I'm not completely sure what he's talking about. Getting the distinct feeling I really can't go this way. But if I can, I will. Oh my. Getting choppy out here. I'm gonna go back. That looks like it's gonna drag me deeper and deeper. So you have multiple passages leading that way. Where can I get back up? Uh-oh. Now you've done it, old chap. You got yourself all poetically messed up. We can get over here. We need shelter from the storm over here. What is this guy doing out here? Is he looking for someone? Is he looking for Esther? Or is he just wandering? Now that lighthouse, I'm guessing I can't get to from where I was. I could see it, but once I got far enough away, all of a sudden I could see it. Pretty flowers. I love stairs like these. Or steps, as they were. It's windy up here, dear Esther. I can't take it anymore. Well... Well... Well, I wanted to go across. So I'm going back this way really quick then. Since now we're down here, I think there's another way up. Why did I... Was that always there? I was too close to see the forest for the trees. Yeah, I mean, that's part of it. But we can't get in that part. Oh. Just now I see there's stairs that used to go up. Oh, I want to go up there. Oh, well. Yes, we were over here. We just can't get up in there. Okay. Might as well go up this way. That's what I was thinking of. And I'll double back, see where it meets up. Pretty. Is it me or is it picking up more as I'm traveling? Oh. This is where I fell down. I literally can't go this way. Oh, I can. What's that? Oh, a post.
Donnelly reported the legend of the Hermit.
He did.
A holy man who sought solitude in its most pure form.
Oi.
Allegedly, he rode here from the mainland in a boat without a bottom, so all the creatures of the sea could rise at night to converse with him. How disappointed he must have been with their chatter. Perhaps now, when all that haunts the ocean is the rubbish dumped from the tankers, he'd find more peace.
I fell here.
They say he threw his arms wide in a valley on the south side, and the cliff opened up to provide him shelter. They say he died of fever 116 years later.
What?
The shepherds left gifts for him at the mouth of the cave, but Donnelly records they never claimed to have seen him. I have visited the cave and I have left my gifts, but like them, I appear to be an unworthy subject of his solitude.
Huh. What gifts did we leave? Why aren't we turning on our flashlight? Oh, I literally can't go this way? Well, how sad. Alright. You would think... Well, alright. That'd be able to go that way. My instinct is to try to jump over it, but there is no jump. I do not have jump. So I want to go up that way, and I'm gonna fall down there in doing so, aren't I? Okay. Nope. Nope. Alright. Well, I think there's only one way up left to us, my dear chaps. Yeah, seen all this before. So these are like crab traps. Crab, lobster, what have you. I love it. There's nothing better in this world than crab legs. Big ones. King crab legs. Take a drink. Something here. That is low res. Surprisingly. Everything else is like a good resolution. More or less. Okay, now we will go this way. The only way we can go. I feel like I'm fighting the wind, walking. I wonder if I am slowing down a little because of the wind.
Reading Donnelly by the weak afternoon sunlight.
Yeah?
He landed on the south side of the island, followed the path to the bay and climbed the mount. He did not find the caves, and he did not chart the north side. I think this is why his understanding of the island is flawed, incomplete. He stood on the mount and only wondered momentarily how to descend. But then, he didn't have my reasons.
Why did you want to descend? What are your reasons then? You falling into the depths of despair?
When someone had died or was dying, or was so ill they gave up what little hope they could sacrifice, they cut parallel lines into the cliff, exposing the white chalk beneath.
Ah.
You could see them from the mainland or the fishing boats, and notice and aid, or impose a cordon of protection, and wait a generation until whatever pestilence stalked the cliff path died along with its hosts. My lines are just for this. To keep any would-be rescuers at bay. The infection is not simply of the flesh.
Huh. What are these? They're just tree trunks, but... You hear that, though? The wind cutting around them? Wow. We're picking up out here.
I quote directly. A motley lot with little to recommend them. I have now spent 3 days in their company. That is, I fear, enough for any man not born amongst them. Despite their tedious inclination to quote scripture, they seem to me the most godforsaken of all the inhabitants of the Outer Isles. Indeed, in this case, the very gravity of that term, forsaken by God, seems to find its very apex. It appears to me that Donnelly, too, found those who wander this shoreline to be adrift from any chance of redemption. Did he include himself in that, I wonder?
Yeah, I don't know what Donnelly includes in, you know... Does Donnelly deserve redemption? Does he want redemption? Does he even care? I don't know. Hello? Who's cracking at my cracking stuff? I like all the crack-a-lackin'. I hear something. Is there a boat down there or something? Sounds like something, like, ran ashore. So I had a bit of music or something, like playing.
Dear Esther, I met Paul. I made my own little pilgrimage. My Damascus, a small semi-detached on the outskirts of Wolverhampton. We drank coffee in his kitchen and tried to connect to one another. Although he knew I hadn't come in search of an apology, reason or retribution, he still spiraled in panic, thrown high and lucid by his own dented bonnet.
Bolt.
Responsibility had made him old. Like us, he'd already passed beyond any conceivable boundary of life.
Oh, that Paul. What's that? Sounds like a radio. Oh, heard it for a second. Should I go in there? A spooky cave? I don't think I can get across the boat. That's where I really like to go. I don't think I can go that way. I really want to. Maybe we can get there another way. Or maybe I can just go there. Okay. Come back. Please don't put me back to the beginning, could you imagine?
Come back.
Okay. I came back. We can't go that way. Well, so what's... I do want to see the cave. What's... I don't know. Yeah, let's go in the cave. You know how long we'd have to walk to get to anywhere new that we haven't seen on the, from the other side?
I would leave you presents outside your retreat in this interim space between cliff and beach.
Oh.
I would leave you loaves and fishes, but the fish stocks have been depleted and I've run out of bread. I would row you back to your homeland in a bottomless boat, but I fear we would both be driven mad by the chatter of the sea creatures.
A bottomless boat? What the hell kind of boat would be a bottomless boat? Here's more of this, like... I don't know. Chemistry diagrams. Inscriptions to ward off evil. Oh, we can't go through. We can only... Okay. We got trees and roots and stuff. Accurately depicted. What's this? Oh, more of the paint. You used all of that. Offerings. Bones. We got bones. Stay away. Stay away, Troll of Doom. I'm not gonna take your bones. Is that something? Don't turn that off yet. I need that light. I'm looking at... Oh, more paint. So there's nothing. There's no... Okay. I thought this was a way through somewhere. I'm surprised a bear doesn't live in here or anything. Could you imagine? Well, this is salt water, but... At least... It should be. But he could catch fish right here, the bear. A living thing. That's not a plant. It went that way. More drink. Barbed wire. There's plenty of gaps between. I mean, really? Is that necessary? I mean, they obviously want to keep people, I'm thinking, from crossing, like, the water, hurting themselves, I guess, when the you know, the water is deeper, slipping and stuff, but why put that there? And you're protecting people and harming them at the same time.
I've become convinced I'm not alone here, even though I'm equally sure it is simply a delusion brought upon by circumstance. I do not, for instance, remember where I found the candles, or why I took it upon myself to light such a strange pathway. Perhaps it is only for those who are bound to follow.